At this moment, the king, who had been for some time busily writing in his notebook, crackled out,
"Silence!"
and read out from his book,
"Rule 42, all persons more than a mile high to leave the court."
Everybody looked at Alice.
"I'm not a mile high,"
said Alice.
"You are," said the king.
"Nearly 2 miles high,"
added the queen.
"Well, I shan't go at any rate. Besides, that's not a real rule. You just made it up right now."
"It's the oldest rule in the book," said the king.
"Then it ought to be number one,"
said Alice. The king turned pale and shut his notebook hastily.
"Consider your verdict,"
he said to the jury in a low, trembling voice.
"There's more evidence to come yet, please, your majesty,"
said the white rabbit, jumping up in a great hurry.
"This paper has just been picked up."
"What's in it?" said the queen.
"I haven't opened it yet," said the white rabbit, "but it seems to be a letter written by a prisoner to somebody."
"It must have been that," said the king. "Unless it was written to nobody, which is unusual, you know."
"Who was it directed to?"
said one of the jurymen.
"It isn't directed at all,"
said the white rabbit.
"In fact, there's nothing written on the outside."
He unfolded the paper as he spoke and added,
"It isn't a letter at all, after all. It's a set of verses."
"Are they in the prisoner's handwriting?"
asked another of the jurymen.
"No, they're not," said the white rabbit. "And that's the queerest thing about it."
The jury all looked puzzled.
"He must have initiated somebody else's hand,"
said the king. The jury all brightened up again.
"Please, your majesty," said the knave, "I didn't write it. They can't prove that I did. There's no name signed at the end."